difference between a collective investment trust and a mutual fund. For many years, the most common investment option in retirement plans has been mutual funds. Collective investment trust, or CIT options, have begun to challenge the dominance of mutual funds in retirement plans. In order to understand the differences between CITs and mutual funds, let's first look at their similarities. Collective investment trusts and mutual funds investment pools money with other investors to create investment portfolios that are tax-exempt, professionally managed, and offer a vast range of investment choices. They both offer daily valuation, which means each investment reports the value of a portfolio on a daily basis. They are audited annually and have fact sheets available. Although they have many similarities, they have some distinct differences, some of which are driving the popularity of CITs. The main differences between a CIT and mutual fund are regulatory body, governing documents, how they report performance, who maintains the product, product availability, pricing flexibility, investment minimums. A mutual fund is regulated by the Securities and Exchange Commission, SEC, under the Investment Company Act of 1940. A CIT is regulated by the Office of the Comptroller of Currency, OCC, as well as the IRS and the Department of Labor. CITs are generally less expensive than mutual funds because of fewer regulatory requirements under the OCC oversight compared with the SEC mutual fund requirements. The governing document for a mutual fund is the prospectus. The CIT is governed by the Declaration of Trust and has operating guidelines. Mutual funds have an annual report that discloses their reporting, and CITs use audited financial statements. A mutual fund is maintained by an asset manager, while a CIT is maintained by a trust company or a bank. Mutual funds are available to all investors. A CIT is only available in a qualified retirement plan. The SEC mandates that mutual funds have the same management fees across all share classes. CIT allows for more flexible management fees through breakpoints depending on asset size. Mutual funds have no investment minimums. CITs could require an investment minimum at the fund level. There are many factors plan officials must consider when trying to determine if a mutual fund or a CIT is the best investment vehicle for their retirement plan. It would be prudent for plan officials to consult with a financial professional on these factors. To learn more about the collective investment trusts and fiduciary best practices, please visit fiduciaryawarenessday.com.